Hey everyone, I'm now in my bedroom in front of my wardrobe and I'm going to purge my clothes collection. I sit in a corner rolled up in a blanket and say, why am I created naked? And I wanted to share some things about it. Actually, you won't think that when you see me in concert dresses and stuff, but clothes and style really have been like a lifetime struggle for me, and that has changed now, and I think the transformation I was going through could be helpful to others, so that's why I'm sharing it here. This is not a violin video, so if you're looking for a violin lesson, I've got nearly 500 here on my channel, so then you might just want to skip this one, and for the ladies perhaps who are interested, keep watching. So from my childhood, I've been very insecure about my body, I've been bullied a lot, and in terms of clothes, I didn't even try to be trendy. I was doing it wrong anyway, and until quite a late age, in my teenage, my mother put my clothes ready for me, what to wear and stuff. She has Hi mom! She doesn't speak English, so... it just has been a struggle. And also, later in life, you might see on this channel that I lose quite a lot of weight. It has been either to cover things up, or when I was slimmer, to be sexy, but never like an authentic personal style. And I never thought I would buy a book about personal style, because fashion was for me something that's like, yeah, that was just a struggle and that's it. So, but I bought this book, and Worthy of Wearing, and I just got this nudge to buy it. Normally I would never have bought a book about this topic, because for me it's just, you know, like this hassle and that's it. This is not a book that shows you like 10 best items, blah blah blah. Actually, the 2/3 of the book is mainly about how we see beauty and how you see your own style. And this is very interesting, because it really goes into the personal part, that it isn't about looking sexy all the time, but more beauty as in beauty, like in a radiant smile or a twinkle in someone's eyes. You know, the beauty that we all have in our unique way, because there's no person in the world who is exactly like you, and God doesn't make mistakes, so you are meant to be exactly how you are now, with all your beautiful features, but also your quirky stuff. it really was very valuable for me to read that, and also that your clothes shouldn't just be like latest trend, but that personal style is really about that your clothes really enhance your natural beauty, and that also it that they support you in doing your living your mission, living your vocation, and that they actually make things easier. So if you really have a clear personal style, you don't struggle with clothes, it doesn't cost you time and energy. And that's kind of what was a big insight for me, that despite I found clothes not important and it was just a struggle, it did cost me a lot of time and energy actually, because it was a struggle. I'm going to purge my wardrobe and make my life a lot simpler. I'm going to sell a lot of items, because I fit into all my pre-pregnancy clothes while I have birthed 3 babies in 1.5 years. My clothes do fit my body, but they don't fit my current lifestyle. They don't fit what I do today, day in, day out. So first I was playing concerts and stuff and all kinds of gigs, and working in my violin shop, and also teaching in my violin studio. And now I work from home and run this online platform, Violin Lounge, this channel. That's now my full-time job. And of course, I've got 3 kids at home, and as good as no childcare. So I'm working in early mornings, naps and evenings. Hope that's going to change soon, perhaps. That's what my clothes should be fitting for, not just my size. which is now the same again, and I'm really happy about it. But yeah, let's go into my wardrobe. So the thing is, as you might know, my husband is like really stylish, like really classic, preppy, and does exactly know what to buy, what to wear and stuff. And so going through the book, I actually took some steps to find out actually what my personal style is, because it's been heavily influenced by other people, and it's not like a creative expression of myself. It doesn't bring me joy. I just wear it for the outside, and that's in that sense vanity and a destruction, instead of a tool that you can use to express yourself and that supports you in whatever you want to achieve in the world. So I went through the Pinterest of Worthy of Wearing, and there are different styles, so you can see what you don't want, and that's most easy because then it leaves you with the style that you do want. And I always thought that preppy was like what I would strive for, but and classic, but I actually discovered I like it very much on other people, like it very much on my husband, but I don't like it on me. I don't feel comfortable in it. And what I discovered is that I really like the romantic or the minimalist style, so maybe you can comment your style below. So I made a Pinterest board to discover my own style, and collected some things. I discovered that, for example, I don't like prints much, like very peaceful colors, except a flower print here and there. So I really like that simple romantic look. So I actually want to transform my wardrobe a little bit to that, and also that they are clothes that are really comfy to wear, very practical to play around with my kids at home, to lift them up, to play with them outside, and to do my computer work, and then also to appear in videos, obviously, because that's what I do. So let's go to purge my wardrobe with this information. Maybe let's start with what I like. Is, for example, this gray dress. I can wear it anywhere, and it's like really comfy, like sweatpants, but a skirt. And so I wear that a lot, and I already own it like 3 years. I washed it so many times, but it's this thick fabric and really moves easily. It's not too short, allows me to do everything. So that's an item that I like very much. Another item is this Ralph Lauren polo vest. It's very light, very soft, fits with everything, wear it a lot. Isn't cheap, of course, but I would buy it again when it wears out, because this is so practical. And then this kind of polo jacket, not Ralph Lauren, but something else. Bought it for very little money 15 years ago, worn it a lot, and it's for Dutch weather here. It's ideal because it can't get very wet, and it's for this like in-between weather, like it's not cold, it's not warm. And so those are items that I like very much. Then for daily life, skirts are very handy, like a beach dress. For Mass on Sunday, I wear it's very long, like lace, dark blue skirt. I wouldn't wear it at home or to the supermarket, but it's for Sundays, and that's okay. But yeah, then I recently bought this blouse dress with buttons, and it's quite long actually, as you can see. You saw it in a couple of my videos, but it's the buttons, I bought it to breastfeed easily, so I can button everything. I can loosen the buttons, but the buttons go loose at any moment. So it's not a practical thing. Like, I lift up one of my toddlers and then, you know, I'm like, whoop! There are some dresses that I really love. Can't wear them because they're like in one piece. Can't breastfeed with them. So yes, I'm going to keep them, but I need something in between while I'm still breastfeeding. Baby Tristan is now 4 months old. I think I'm going to breastfeed until he's one or so. So yeah. Well, of course, I've got my portion of black dresses, you know, orchestra gigs. And I also got a beautiful like wool wrap dress in brown, and wore it with the baptism of all my kids. It's really comfy, it's really warm, I can breastfeed with it because it's rock dress. So this is a really good item to have, but I'm not wearing it often. Again, this is not like daily suitable clothes. So then there's something like this. It's the beautiful silk thingy. Probably those of you who are following me longer have seen it in videos, but I'm just not wearing it because it leaves so much naked. I'm not saying that it's a bad thing, but I'm just looking for things that like match what I do now and how I am. And you know, if you are maybe dating or whatever, it might be nice to have something like that. But I'm going to sell that one. So it's also a dress. It's rather dressed and rather short. It doesn't have sleeves, but at the same time it's very heavy. So in hot weather you sweat, and in cold weather, you need something on it, and then I don't have that, and well, ends up that I'm not wearing it, so it's going away. Then there are dresses that are just too girly for me. It's like you don't have to fit it and stuff, and it'd be practical, but clothes have to kind of fit the season you're in, fit how you like to look or bring your joy. So I'm going to sell these because it's just, you know, it's just too girly. Let's grow up. Usually I'm buying work clothes instead of just practical clothes. This dress is like beautiful. I wore it in several videos. When you move, it's beautiful, but it's like really short. Like I can't really wear it on Sundays. I just don't like to wear like very short skirts. Again, this person, I'm a complete mess when it comes to fashion, so don't take my advice. And I'm not judging others. It's, you know, it's just about my personal choice, and maybe you can find your personal choice from that. It's just not comfortable to wear in daily life. So I'm also going to try to sell this one because, yeah, when will I wear it? Then two dresses, same story. It's kind of short, and it's kind of dressed up. So it's not something I would ever wear at home or to the supermarket. And don't wear it on Sunday. So yeah, when am I going to wear it? I mean, if you go out a lot again, and that's your current life, then you know, something like this can be very fitting. Also going to sell a lounge set because it's not really, really comfy. And if I have like lounge clothes, they have to be really, really comfy. So I'm not wearing it again because it's not dressed up. So, you know, and at home, I just want to wear comfy stuff. And I'm also going to sell a couple of shirts just because they are impossible to combine and they're quite nice anyway. And thanks to the book that I read, I'm really going for things that really fit my season of life, really bring joy. Like in this day-to-day practical life, they need to be washable, they need to be kind of stylish, kind of beautiful, a lot less prints and a lot less preppy. So that's kind of the process, and I'm going to sell them, and then I'm going to use that budget to invest in some pieces. And I hope that my wardrobe will be a lot smaller. It's now like this, and at least more than half of it is going out, and I'm going to invest in just a couple of very nice items that I love and that are comfortable and washable and all these things. So that was my process, but it will look entirely different for you if you're working in corporate, or if you have entirely different taste, or the book also describes like what fits your body type. For example, I have like wide hips and a small waist. So for me, like A-line skirt is good, and everything that kind of defines the waist. So I'll link to this book in the comments below. But I'm really happy to look forward to that. I don't see fashion or clothing as kind of vanity or distraction or kind of a struggle, but that I'm really looking forward, like pinning stuff and finding this this style that I really like. It's really for the first time in my life that I'm looking at clothes in a positive way. And this book has really changed that for me. It's not that I just want to, you know, go sit in a corner rolled up in a blanket and say, why am I created naked? So that's kind of what it was in the previous year. So at least I hope to have given you a better feeling about how you are, because I think I'm quite extreme in this. And I hope you like this video. So yeah, you know, if you recognize some things in this video, then let's talk with each other in the comments about this, because yeah, it's really comfortable for me to talk about it, but I hope it's kind of helpful for others. So bye.